Have you noticed that Sarah has been very secretive as of late?
Yes, I have. She's definitely up to no good. I think she is trying to sabotage our project.
What makes you say that?
I overheard her talking on the phone to one of our competitors about joining their team.
Are you serious?
Yeah. Maybe we should confront her about it?
Good idea. Let's not make assumptions.
All right, so now that we've seen them talking, actually now we will look at their conversation again sometime later. What's his name? John. John actually confronted Sarah when he ran into her.
That's right.
Let's find out exactly what happened.
John and Jane are having a text message conversation, and we will listen to that right now.
Oh my gosh, Jane!
What?
I ran into Sarah today, so I asked her about why she hasn't been pulling her weight and why she seems so secretive.
And?
Turns out she has been plotting against us.
Are you serious? I knew she was up to no good.
She gave away all our research to another company in return for double the salary that she makes here.
Wow, double the salary. That's pretty good.
Is that what you are paying attention to?
Yeah.
No, it's not important here.
It's not, but I mean, because people do mean things, bad things, but usually it's because of some other reason. Like in this case, double the salary.
Yeah, that's the reason here. That's the motive here. So let's talk about two lines. 여기 지금 문자 메시지에서 주고받았던 말들 중에서 두 문장을 골라서 자세히 공부를 해보는 시간입니다. 첫 번째는 어떤 문장 걸까요?
Okay, so the first one that we'll look at is, I ran into Sarah today. So I asked her about why she hasn't been pulling her weight and why she seems so secretive. I ran into Sarah today. So I asked her about why she hasn't been pulling her weight and why she seems so secretive.
네, I ran into라고 하는 것은 우연히 만났다라는 말이죠. Run into. 그래서 우연히 bump into 똑같은 말입니다. 그래서 우연히 만나서 왜 pulling her weight 하고 있는지, 왜 so secretive 해 보이는지를 물었다고 했는데 두 가지 표현 중에서 먼저 secretive는 아까 배웠고요. 비밀스러운 거고
That's right.
pulling her weight. 재밌는 표현이에요.
That's right. So if you're not pulling your weight, the other people have to do more to pull the ship or to pull the cart or whatever we're pulling.
Yeah. 약간 예를 들어서 여러분이 무언가에 탔어요. 어떤 것을 탔고 그것을 뭐 바퀴가 없기 때문에 밧줄로 끌어당겨서 다 같이 움직여야 되는 그런 상황을 생각해 보세요. 뭐 엘리베이터라든지 아니면 뭔가 수레에 탔는데 끌어야 되는 거예요. 그런데 모두가 끌고 있는데 나만 안 끌고 있으면
Right. Or just a little bit. One arm.
그냥 손만 얹고 있으면 내가 해야 되는 일만큼 남들이 해야 되잖아요.
Right.
그것을 pull one's weight라고 하는 거죠. 내 몫을
right.
하다. 근데 she hasn't been pulling her weight. 일에 자신의 몫을 안 한다라는 말은 일에 참여를 안 하는 거예요. 일을 손 놓고
right.
있는 거죠. 그래서
right.
요즘에 왜 일을 다 자기 일을 다 안 하고 또는 손 놓고 있고 이렇게 비밀스럽게 행동하는지를 ran into 한 다음에 즉 우연히 만난 다음에 물었다라는 말이죠. 그 다음에 어떤 말이 나오고 있나요?
All right. So then the next one that we chose for you guys is turns out she has been plotting against us. Turns out she has been plotting against us.
알고 보니 우리에 대해서 음모를 꾸미고 있더라고 라는 말인데요. 일단 plot 하면 영화에서 plot은 어떤 구성이에요.
Right. So 네. in the movie, the plot is like the storyline.
네, 줄거리죠. 그래서 plot이고 plot을 꾸민다고 하는 것은 사실 어떤 계획을 꾸민 것
Right. 수도 so 있겠고. You can be making plots. It could be a evil plots. Usually we use it for evil. Evil plots. And 네. another word is schemes. Evil schemes.
그래서 이 plot 자체는 사실 뭐 나쁜 건 아닐 수 있는데
right.
일반적으로는 나쁜 뜻으로 쓰입니다.
Right.
게다가 plot for 누구누구라고 하면 그 사람을 위해서 음모를 꾸며주어서 그 사람이 이득을 보게끔 말하는 건데 plot against라고 하면
right.
그 against 다음에 나오는 사람들이 피해를 보게 되는 거죠.
Right. So you're trying to do something bad to them. You're trying to sabotage their work or their life in
네.
some way.
여러분이 잘 알고 계시는 fight against, 누구와 대항해서 mm-hmm. 싸우다 또는 뭐 argue against라든지 mm-hmm. 그런 말들과 비슷한 느낌입니다. Plot 하긴 하는데 against us니까 mm-hmm. 우리에게 해방이 되는 또는 어떤 피해가 우리에게 있는 방향으로 mm-hmm. 음모를 꾸미는 거죠. 그래서 mm-hmm. 알고 보니 plot against us 하고 있더라고까지 mm-hmm. 결론이 났습니다. So I don't know what they're gonna do.
I don't know.
Yeah, we'll never find out what happens.
We won't ever find out.
Because the conversation won't continue from there. 그렇지만 we will find out what Eden has to say about what she did that her parents didn't like before.
Oh, wow, that was good use of the word. So now it's time for us to watch the clip we watched at the beginning of the show, okay, that Eden sent to us. This time there won't be any subtitles, so make sure you keep your ears open, listen carefully. Let's watch.
I was always a very good child. My parents always said that they were very blessed to have me. I never really got into trouble, and my parents didn't have many rules about things they didn't like me doing because I generally didn't do things that they didn't like. So if I had to think of one thing that they didn't like, it was watching TV or playing video games before I'd finished all of my homework. And I used to lie sometimes about whether I had finished my homework. I would only do one page and say that I had finished all of it. But I used to kind of self-police because I felt so guilty about lying to my parents that I wouldn't lie again for months after that.
네, 이든 씨가 했던 말 중에서 마지막 부분에 재밌는 말이 하나 나오고 있죠.
Yeah, so she said self-police.
네, 오늘의 키워드인데요. Self-police는 뭘까요, 도대체?
So self-police means that you are, you know, kind of holding yourself to some kind of rules or laws and enforcing them.
네, 약간 자제를 하는 거죠. 그래서 사실 아무도 모르고 이걸 안 지켜도 또는 몰래 간식 좀 먹어도 아무도 모르는데 죄책감이 들어서 죄책감으로 self-police를 하는 겁니다. 그래서 had some kind of self-police라는 형태로 이 문장을 만들었습니다. 그래서 스스로 자제를 했다 정도로 이해하시면 좋겠고 또는 죄책감을 느꼈다도 되겠습니다. 자, 그리고 이든 씨가 했던 말들 중에서 두 문장 정도 볼 텐데요. 첫 번째 어떤 문장 볼까요?
Okay, so the first sentence that we'll look at is So if I had to think of one thing that they didn't like So if I had to think of one thing that they didn't like
부모님이 안 좋아했던 일을 하나 골라야 한다면, 생각해 보자면 이라는 말인데 이 문장을 고른 이유는 If I have to 라고 하지 않고 mm-hmm. If I had to 라고 했어요.
That's right, because it's in the past.
네, 그런데 이 과거로 썼잖아요. Mm. 과거로 썼기 때문에, 즉 예전에 골라야 했다면 이라는 말로도 썼지만 가정을 하면서도 사실 이렇게 쓰고 있습니다. 뭐 굳이 골라야만 한다면 Because she didn't do anything
right.
that her parents didn't like.
Didn't like. Right.
그렇지만 굳이 골라야만 한다면 이라는 뜻을 담고 싶기 때문에 과거란 뜻도 있겠고 여기서는 또 그런 가정을 하면서 굳이 골라야만 한다면 이라는 느낌으로 말하고 싶기 때문에 mm-hmm. If I had to, I wouldn't have to, but if I had to
right.
네, 그런 뜻으로 쓰고 있고요. Mm-hmm. 두 번째 문장은요?
Okay, so the second one that we'll look at is I would only do one page and say that I'd finished all of it. I would only do one page and say that I'd finished all of it.
숙제를 one page, 한 페이지만 하고는 I finished all of it, 다 했다고 하는 거죠 라는 말인데
right.
여기서 이것을 고른 이유는 앞에 나왔던 그 if I had to와 비슷한 느낌입니다. Mm-hmm. I would는 물론 가정법은 아니고 이제 예전에 있었던 일들 mm-hmm. 저는 뭐뭐 하곤 했어요 라고 할 때 mm-hmm. 나열하겠죠. 저는 뭐 아침 7시에 일어나곤 했고 mm-hmm. 뭐 10살 때 아침에 7시에 일어났고 그 다음에 뭘 했고 뭘 했고 할 때 I would go to school, I would meet friends, would가 필요 없을 것 같지만 과거에 자주 하던 일을 나열할 때 would를 써줍니다.
Right. And it's kind of like a thing that we use a lot. So if I had to choose one thing, mm-hmm. I would choose blah blah blah.
네, 그렇죠. 그래서 앞에 나왔던 문장과 여기 나왔던 문장 두 가지 용법을 좀 구분해서 이해할 수 있어야 되겠습니다. Mm-hmm. 자, 오늘 공부는 여기까지 해보고요. Mm-hmm. 네, 이든 씨의 영상을 다시 한번 한국어 영화 자막 넣어서 감상하시면서 마무리하겠습니다.
I was always a very good child. My parents always said that they were very blessed to have me. I never really got into trouble, and my parents didn't have many rules about things they didn't like me doing, because I generally didn't do things that they didn't like. So if I had to think of one thing that they didn't like, it was watching TV or playing video games before I'd finished all of my homework. And I used to lie sometimes about whether I had finished my homework. I would only do one page and say that I had finished all of it. But I used to kind of self-police because I felt so guilty about lying to my parents that I wouldn't lie again for months after that.
Eden was such a good child.
Yeah, awesome.
And luckily, because I think our parents usually know when we're up to no good.
맞아요. 뭔가 부모님을 속이고 뭘 해보려고 해도 대충 다 아시죠? Mm-hmm. 아시지만 눈 감아주는 겁니다. Mm-hmm. 그래서 I think Eden was a really good child, and I'm sure you were also a very good child.
I actually was. What about you?
I think I was too.
Really?
Yeah, we're all good.
We're all children. Good children.
자, 그런데 가끔씩 아이들이기 때문에 mm-hmm. 장난도 치고 동생 장난감도 뺏고 이럴 수 있잖아요. 그럴 mm-hmm. 때 I was up to no good 이런 말 쓸 수 있습니다.
That's right. He was up to no good.
Only sometimes.
All the time.
Not all the time, but only sometimes, I admit. 자, 그래서 오늘 배워봤던 표현들 여러분 복습해 보시기를 바라겠고요. 복습을 하시려면 저희 웹사이트 방문하시면 가장 쉽게 복습하실 수 있습니다.
Yes, you can. And next time we'll teach you more useful expressions. Thanks for studying with us here today. We'll see you guys next time.
네, 여러분 안녕히 계세요. Bye bye.
Goodbye.